What do you do after learning Python? At university, you apply it. There are various common areas that you learn, such as databases and data structures and algorithms. But first, you must understand objects. And this is where we start in this series of Python and the next level. To be able to code using object-oriented programming, you must understand objects. So in this video, we're going to give a simple but essential explanation of objects. Watch everything in this video, as the next videos will give more detail. There is more to OO, such as OO design, but we focus on using Python. If you have any aspects of objects that you wish to learn, then leave a comment. But for now, let's introduce objects and explain objects in as simple language as we can. Sometimes the concept of objects can seem a bit difficult and confusing. That's normally down to the language used to explain them. So let's try something very simple. So here's an image. It's a dog. Here's another picture. It's another dog. The first picture, second picture, they are dogs. Image one, this is dog one. Image two, this is dog two. Dog 2 is a different dog than dog 1. Now, let's explain that again, but in OO language. Here is an object. Here is another object. 1 and 2 are dog objects. This image is an instance of a dog object. This image is of the same object type, but a different instance of the dog object. So we can see that using the language of objects and instances can be a bit confusing at the start, but essentially objects are things. Dog's a thing, a second dog is another thing, but it's a different dog. So we have two objects, they are the same type of object, they're dogs, but they're different instances, they're different dogs. That's essentially what you need to understand with objects. If you've got two dogs, how do you know which one's which? Well, they have a name. We can assume that all dogs have a name, have an age, and have an owner. These might be different for different dogs, but all dogs have these three attributes. So if we're going to create an object that describes a dog, we'll need to get its name, its age, and the name of the owner. So for example, the first dog is called Lucky, and he's 4 years old, and he's owned by myself, so we can put Codie as the owner. The second dog is Lucky's brother, called Goldie. He's also 4, they're born at the same time, and owned by myself, again Codie. So we have two dog objects, they're dogs. They're not the same dog, one's Lucky and one's Goldie. So when we create them in a computer program, we have two dogs, two objects of dog type, and they have the attributes, name, age, and owner. And the first dog is Lucky, he's 4, owned by Codie. Second dog is Goldie, 4 years old, owned by Codie. So we have dog 1, dog 2. They are different instances of the same object. Here is a cat. Now a cat will have a name, an owner, and an age. But a cat is not a dog. But a cat is an animal, and a dog is an animal. So this might be important later on when we look at trying to reuse in code. So dog 1 was a type of dog. Dog is a type of animal, so therefore dog 1, Lucky, is a type of animal. So if we was writing a program for, let's say, a farm where we had many animals, we wouldn't want to keep repeating writing the same code. We would reuse this. This is where something called inheritance is important, which we'll look at in this series. But for now, let's start looking at the Python code, the syntax. First of all, we've seen classes before, if we print the type of the integer 7, or the floating point 7.0, or the string 7, you can see the output says class int, class float, class string. So these are all classes. Now we want to create our own class. So we define a class, just the word class, then the class name, then the colon, and we have code underneath. When we create the object, then we create a variable, in this example dog1, and then we make that equal the object, which is the class name, in this case dog, with an uppercase letter to start off with, and the brackets. So this creates the dog object. So you can see the name of the class is dog, and when we create the object we also use dog with the brackets. Inside the class we have, instead of variables, we have attributes. So variables inside a class are called attributes. And we have methods. Inside a class we have functions, but when they're inside a class we call them methods. So variables and functions are called attributes and methods. So in our dog class we had the variables, or we're going to call them attributes inside the class, name, age and owner. So when we create a dog we want to know their name, age and owner. So we can create the class dog, and we start off with no name. So when we create the dog, we create the code, the object, and then we can give it a name. So dog1 was called Lucky, dog2 was called Goldie. So we can print the name using dog1.name, dog2.name. So you can see we're using dot and then the attribute. So dog1.name, dog2.name, when we print that, we print Lucky and Goldie. So that's printing the attribute. Now we see when we look at our classes previously, we have the class name like string and int and type, but we also have variables that we can pass as parameters. So this is like a function, but it's different. In a class you don't put the parameter in the brackets like you would in a function. You can't do that. Now what about if we created a function, which we're going to call a method inside a class, and pass it to that? Well, unfortunately it's not that straightforward. What we use is something called self, and this magic word self means that we can create these attributes and they can be used anywhere within the class. So you can think of a variable inside a function that has the scope within that function but not outside. So self allows us to do that within the class. So when we create the attribute, we can use it anywhere inside any method or anywhere within the class. So it's important to understand this self. So we'll explain this as we go through the videos. But you can see in this example, we've created this function, which again, remember, we're going to call a method because it's inside the class, getName. Now we pass it a name, like Lucky or Goldie, and in this case we're using the parameter n. Now to make the name inside that class equal that name, we use self.name. So the attribute's called name, we put self.name, so we know that's the name inside our class. So this self is very important. Now if we look at the code, we can create dog1 and dog2, we can get name. So we've got Lucky and Goldie. Now we didn't pass anything except for the name, which was the end part. So this self we don't need to worry about outside. and then we printed it, dog1.name, dog2.name, and the output, Lucky and Goldie. So this whole idea of self is only inside the class. So now we don't need to put this attribute underneath class. It doesn't make any difference. So this beginning function method that we created this name is a way of initializing it, like creating the object for the first time. And to do that properly, we give that method a special name. Instead of initialize, we shorten it to init, init, short for initialize. But also, you will see here, there's two underscores before and after. So this is quite a unique name. With classes, these method names, there are some that already exist. We don't need to see them, we don't need to change them, but we can if we want. So we have methods that we can access from outside, and there's methods that are already kind of inside. So this initialize method is something that we can set up when we set up the object. So when, if you like, when we create the object, so in this example, dog1 equals dog, we want to give the dog the name at the start. We want to make sure the dog has a name. So when we create the dog, in brackets, we have the name, Lucky. Now that passes to the initialization method. And now, because we use self.name, the name of that dog is going to be Lucky. The second dog, called Goldie, the same thing happens. So now we have a simple class called dog. We have this method where when we create the object, we get the name as well. We use the self to make sure we can use that name any site, any place within the class. And we set up the name when we create the dog. So in this example, dog1 and dog2. In this video, we're not going to explain all the details. We'll explain these in the videos in the coming weeks. So we have class methods, are the functions inside a class, and the variables inside a class are called attributes. So we define the class, we have attributes and methods, and when we create the object, we use the class name. So those are the basics of the class. Finally, if we, in our example, we had the dog name, the age, and the owner, we can put them in like parameters, the same as we would do a normal function in this side in the method. Remember, we have to use self all the time. So self.name, self.age, self.owner. So this is our final code at the beginning of this series on objects. We can see that we can create the object using a class. So we'll explain this in detail in the forthcoming videos. Okay, I hope you join us for the next week when we start going into more detail of what we explained. But if you like this video, please give us a like. And if you haven't already, please subscribe. See you for the next video.